Welcome to the newly opened Biocontainment Unit at Johns Hopkins Hospital. I'm Elizabeth Tracy, here with Nisa Ernst, the nurse manager of the Biocontainment Unit. Nisa, this has been quite a long journey getting to this point.
Elizabeth, it certainly has. We started this project in October of 2014. We knew that we needed to have a response to the Ebola epidemic, so we went out and we went out to our peers across the country who already had units that were open. And we learned from those peers what their best practices were and how we could incorporate that here at Johns Hopkins Hospital.
Is it okay if we take a look?
I would love to take you on a tour of this facility.
Well, it looks like primary colors are the ones that are used here on this unit.
Elizabeth, there's a specific reason for that. One of the things that our architects came up with was this color coding door system so that we knew what to do when we were here on the unit. For instance, a green door means that you can go through that door. A yellow door means that you'll have to do something before you go through that door, and that's going to be detailed instructions right there on that placard. And a red door means that unless there's an emergency, you're not going to go through that door. The unit is unidirectional, and the door colors really help with that process.
Nisa, here we are in a typical patient room, and there's a lot of high-tech things going on here. What are some of them?
The flooring and the walls are one sealed unit. All of the self-selectors are going to be maintaining the environment of care here on this unit, so it's important to us that we have very little space to become another of what we refer to as a vector for infection. The other thing that we have is our Polycom system. Our Polycom system is a computerized system that will allow us to do consults with other providers without them having to come onto the unit.
And then there's the laminar airflow.
We went with an air handling unit that exceeds the industry standards for air exchanges per hour. All of those air exchanges are also vented out to the roof of the institution, so it's not coming back into this unit or any of the other units in the hospital.
So we're well prepared for whatever infectious disease emerges.
We're well prepared for whatever infectious diseases emerge, Elizabeth.
Wow, Nisa, it's kind of loud in here. Does it have to be this loud in the lab?
It does have to be this loud in the labs because of the air handling system that's venting to the roof. This is a BSL-2 level lab. That's Biosafety 2 level. This lab here will do all of our testing for the BCU, so we will not have to go to any other lab areas in the institution. That's again based on that same concept of what comes here on the unit stays here on the unit.
Nisa, we know that with Ebola patients, there's a tremendous amount of waste that's generated. And of course, that's all infectious. What are we going to do about that here?
Here on this unit, Elizabeth, we're going to utilize our two independently operating autoclaves. This is the side of the unit where we're going to insert the waste. And on the other side of the unit is where the waste is going to come out sterilized. So the waste that is sterilized is going to be taken from the unit on a very specific pattern and handled by Stericycle, who is our current supplier.
It sure looks to me like everything you could need is right here.
We want to make sure that we have the supplies that we need. We also want to make sure that what comes onto this unit stays on this unit. It does not go back out through the rest of the system. So it's important to us to make sure that we have the right product here at the right time.
And the Pyxis machine helps with that.
The Pyxis helps tremendously. We're trying also on this unit to maintain the same standards that we have around the institution because it's easier to train a self-selector group on systems that they're already used to. Hence why we came up with our BCU-specific Pyxis.
This, of course, is a teaching hospital, so lots and lots of people consult on cases. I imagine that's going to be true here, too.
It is, and that's also a challenge because you're talking about adding one more person to the infection control vector. So one of the things that we've done here on the BCU is to have this physician consult room where providers, whether it's physical therapy, social work, pastoral care, can all come up into this room through our Polycom video system. They're going to be able to see the patient. They're going to be able to see how the patient is doing, and they're going to be able to write their consult based upon that, and then we can implement it out there on the floor. Again, no need for someone to garb up and come into the unit.
Nisa, this looks like the nerve center of the unit.
Elizabeth, that's a really good term for this because this is not business as usual. So this is not just the nurse's station. It really is the hub for the unit. This is where all the different providers are going to come in and have a daily huddle. You'll notice that everything is mobile and cleanable. That reduces the risk of infection. We also do this in a great teamwork, collaborative environment, and that's one of the many things that's unique to the Biocontainment Unit.